Our museums, galleries, libraries and archives are responsible for safely storing collection items to be accessed and enjoyed for generations to come. But at the moment, many institutions are using different systems to manage their collections. So what is available in one can be hard to find by someone working or researching in another. There is an answer, and it's already being tried and tested in some of the leading heritage organisations across the UK. A persistent identifier, or a PID, is a unique and permanent ID that can be associated with any kind of content, whether that's a person, an object, piece of data, or research article.
Persistent identifiers are the cornerstone of connected knowledge. If you want to connect information from the British Library to the V&A to the Royal Botanical Gardens in Edinburgh, you need to be able to know how you connect one institution, one object, one plant to a painting that that plant is illustrated in. Persistent identifiers provide the connecting points between one piece of information and another piece of information. And if you can trust it and it persists, then your knowledge continues.
One of the benefits of PIDs is that if the collection management system changes in one institution, as long as a PID is assigned, the items still remain discoverable for everyone.
If we were able to create this museum data system, then we would create a data lake of hundreds of millions of museum object records that are currently not available. And you would be able to search across them, and because they were persistent, they would be there over the long term.
And the research opportunities are vast.
Once PIDs begin to be applied to all sorts of content, it potentially surfaces information about people and places and events that haven't been very well studied previously. And this can be incredibly important for inclusivity and making sure that our research is as diverse and wide-ranging as possible.
They also make working with data easier for heritage professionals.
By bringing PIDs into our workflows, we've been able to make our processes more efficient, more reliable, and to provide a better service to our users.
Persistent identifiers help us work out how people are using our collection, which then informs what we collect in the future.
And the more institutions adopt PIDs, the more useful they become. The use of PIDs opens up regional, national, and international collections and allows us to connect more of the world's data. Has your organisation considered adopting PIDs to manage your collections? Find out more today.
Our museums and galleries hold objects which are hundreds and hundreds of years old. Here's hoping our digital content can be used and explored for the same period of time.